We stumbled into a thousand, stood there freezing cold and tired out, shivering and miserable in front of meagre fire. And your old man says, "Cheers, lad, I've got you some nice brown bread and butter for your tea." He and my father went crackers. He reached out and gently pulled my man towards him, big throat. "You big, fat, idle, ugly wart," he said. "You get useless, stony-eyed, parrot-faced wizard." He'd away with words, my father. "Been to college, you know." He said, "You've been out playing bingo often, and you said I get some proper snap ready for me and this lad," he explained to me poor little purple-faced man. Then turning to me, he says, "Arthur," he could never remember my name, "he's here for crown, lad, nip down to Chipoil and gives a nice piece of haddock for his tea. Man cannot live by bread alone." He was a tear to me, father. He said, "As our working folk should have some dignity and pride and self-respect, and as either should come home to something warm and cheerful." Then he threw my mum on fire. We didn't have no tellies, or shoes, or bedclothes. We made his own fun in them days. Do you know, when I was a lad, you could catch a tram and tip down, buy three new suits and an overcoat, four pair of good boots, go see George Formby at Palace Theatre, get blind drunk, have some steak and chips, a bunch of bananas and 3 stone of monkey nuts, and come home with change out of the farthing. Mind you, we had lots of things in them days we don't have to do. Rickets, diphtheria, Hitler. And by, we did look well going to school with all backside in his trousers and all his little heads painted purple because we all had ringworm. I don't know what born today.